today we are studying engine geology, and in engine geology today contents are landslides and subsidence, their classification, causes and their preventions. What does landslide refers to? Landslide refers to the downward sliding of huge quantities of landmass which occur along steep slopes of hills or mountains and may be sudden or slow. So this is landslide is, as everybody knows, that it is downward sliding of the soil mass, especially when there will be rainfall, because of mainly because of the poor water pressure develops in the soil, and it is along the steep slope that will so that the gravity pull of the earth will be taken into account, and because of that there will be a sudden movement of the entire land mass. That refers to the landslide. So the classification of earth movements, these are the basic three classifications of earth movements. One is earth flow, another is landslide, and next is subsidence. What is earth flow? Earth flow is a flow of earth around, it's like a slurry with the especially when there will be rainfall. Then the different types of classification of earth flow are solidification, creep, rapid flows. It is a sudden flow of earth. Landslide is debris slide or slump, rock slides and rock falls. But subsidence is plastic flow of earth or soil mass, and it's a collapse state. So what does solidification mean? Solidification is a downward movement of wet soil along the slopes under influence of gravity. So it mainly happens in rain, when there will be a rainfall, and it is basically a flow of earth, especially flow of slurry, when water and rainwater mixed with the soil, the soil which get eroded on the surface, that flows along with the water in the form of slurry, and that named as solidification. What does soil creep mean? Creep is extremely slow downward movement of dry surficial matter. So it is not wet, it is dry. It is very slow movement, downward movement in the influence of gravity of this dry surface matter. Movement of the soil occurs in regions were subjected to freezing thawing conditions. So the regions where freezing and thawing conditions are subjected, in that region this creep is very predominant. And the alternate freezing and thawing cycles of the soil will actually activates or will triggers the creep. The freeze lifts the particle of soil and rocks, and when there is a thaw. So when there is a freeze, the volume will increase, the water stored in the pores, the volume will increase and it will lift the soil, and the thaw again sets back, but not at the same location. Then the location will be changed and the particles there are set back down, but not in the same place or location. So this is how soil creeps take place. What does rapid flow mean? Rapid flow is similar to the creep but differ in terms of speed and depth. It's just almost same as creep, but it differs in speed and depth. It will be faster. It has a very less time of occurrence, and it has a good depth. It is at the good depth and speed. Creep is involved up to shallow depth of 1 to 2 meters, whereas the rapid flow is involved to the great depth of 5 meters or more. So this is the basic difference between rapid flow and creep. Now, what is something about landslide? If mass of Earth moves along a definite plane or surface, the failure is termed as landslide. So this, you can see an example. This is landslide. This is along this the failure plane, which is indicated here. Around the failure plane, the soil gets eroded in the influence of gravity, and especially when there will be rainfall. Large block known as slump block moves during this time. So during when there will be slide, that is like then the slump, the lump of the soil will move together all together under the influence of the gravity. They can occur along a slope where the internal resistance of the blocks are reduced, or they lose their holding capacity. So once there will be rainfall, especially when there will be rainfall, the pore water generated into the pores of the soil matter present in that steep area of the land. Then that pore water forces the it will have an internal force, and that forces the matter, soil matter, outward. And once there will be the force of outward, then the shear strength of the soil will get reduced, and as a result of this, the landslide occurs. Common after earthquake or after removal of part of slope due to construction, particularly for construction of roads. So this is a common phenomena, especially when we construct a road. When we construct a road, suppose this is a road, when we have constructed, what we do, we scrap out the nearby hill or the steeper slopes and take soil from them and put on the embankment or whatever we are designing at the time, and that itself triggers, that it itself just take just alter the land area, and once there will be alteration in the land present nearby the steep slope, it triggers the landslide in a very long time. It is not just less time phenomena. It takes time. It's gradual. It occurs gradually, and once it occurs again, that it will produce the destruction and may cause to harm to human life. During the movement of landslide, these can be resulted debris slides, which are the failure of unconsolidated matter on a surface, rock slide, where movement of large blocks rolls. They are also common along the steep banks of the rivers and lakes. So once they are also common in the banks, because the banks are also steeper, and as we know that main cause is pore water pressure, so they occur near the banks of the rivers and lakes too. And the pore water pressure is the key to monitoring landslide. Shear strength decreases landslide, and this happens because the shear strength decreases. So the monitoring key factor of monitoring is pore water pressure. We should always consider the pore water pressure while designing a road near a hill or a steeper slope area. So we have to just take care of this slope, and we have to just see whether if we are scrapping out the material through this plane, the steeper plane, we must again alter it and correct it such that it does not fall over the road area. So what is talus? Talus is this one, you can see in the figure. Accumulation formed by the coarser rock fragment related from the mechanical weathering along a slope under the influence of gravity. So once there will be mechanical weathering, then along it the block, small, bigger and small blocks of the rock fall down from the slope and accumulate at the bottom, and that part is known as talus. Now, what does subsidence mean? It represents the downward movement of surface, as same as earth flow and landslide, but It may occur due to plastic outflow of the underlying strata or due to the compaction of the underlying material. So it does not necessarily mean that the surface of the land should move. It can occur due to the plastic flow of the layer below the surface layer. Substance due to there are two types of substance. Substance due to, as we have classified, substance due to plastic outflow. It may occur when a plastic layer like clay bed is squeezed outward due to the overlying heavy load. Substance due to collapse. It occurs due to the extensive pullout of larger volume of underground water or due to the subsurface erosion activity in the limestone terrain. So these are the basic the requirements to for a subsidence. Especially the water is the main enemy of poor. These are the examples of subsidence. So Leaning Tower of Pisa is the prime example of how subsidence created a wonder. Now, what are the causes of landslides? Internal cause. What are the internal cause? Influence of slope. We know influence of slope. If it is a steeper slope, then there will be more chance of landslide, and there will be more gravity pull towards the inclination. That if you are keeping more steeper slope, that provides a favorable condition for landslide. Steeper slopes are prone to slippage of land because there will be more water pressure once there will be rainfall, and there will be more gravity pull downward. It is known that most of the material are stable up to certain angle, that known as critical angle or angle of repose. It varies from 30 degree for unconsolidated sediments to 90 degree for massive rocks and 60 to 90 degree for partially jointed rocks. So we should take care of the slope. Now next is groundwater. Main factor responsible for slippage. Groundwater or water is main factor. Suppose the hard or massive rocks are underlined by softer rocks, say shale or clay. So when rain percolates through some fractures or joints, the clay beds becomes very plastic and unstable and act as slippery base, which enhances the chances of loose overburden to slip downward. So once the water enters into the bed or the layer below the rock layer, that layer which has the clay or shale, it starts behaving as a plastic layer, and then it loses its shear strength and moves down. Along with that, the upper layer which constitutes rock also moves down. So this happens at the time. What is the most powerful solvent which not only causes decomposition of minerals but also leaches out the soluble matter of the rock and reduces the strength? So water affects other causes are lithology. Rock which are rich in clay, example montmorillonite, bentonite, mica, calcite, gypsum, etc., prone to landslide because these minerals are prone to weathering. So these are the weak minerals and they are prone to weathering. That's why these are the most dangerous if they are in some layer. Occurrence of inclined bedding, planes, joints, fault, shear zone, any other plane weakness which create the condition of instability. So when there will be an instability in the slope, then there is chance of landslide or subsidence. Human influence, undercutting of the hill slopes and for the laying roads in examples, then deforestation. These are the basic things. So these are the internal causes of the landslide. What are the external causes? Most commonly is vibration related due to the earthquake, blasting, explosives, volcanic eruptions, etc. So the external are mainly earthquakes and the human activity by explosive in the mining area. Earthquake often initiate mass failure from the large scale. So if there is an earthquake, which is not a man-made created, but if it is a natural disaster, then it triggers the landslide, and it can trigger landslide in many areas, especially even with the slope which are steeper but they are stable, it can initiate those also, and it can trigger the mass destruction due to the various landslides. What are the preventive measures of this? The main factor which contribute to landslide are slope, water content, geological structure, unconsolidated or loose sediments, lithology, and human interference. Slope, retaining wall may be constructed against the slope, which can prevent rolling down of material. Tracing of the slope is an effective measure. So you can make a retaining wall to retain the structure. If at all there is a landslide, you can retain the volume which is being falling over that slope, and it can just prevent the debris which may damage the road structure or any structure and human life. Now, then pass a slope under its effect of water, make proper drainage network for quick removal of percolating moisture or rainwater by constructing ditches and water ways along this slope. So we have to take care of the slope by making proper ditches, by making it almost like when there, as soon as there will be rainfall, then the water should percolate, should not percolate inside, and it should either drain out very very fast, so that we have to make the ditches and the ways, we have to construct water ways so that the slope will not, should not be in contact with the water for more time. Now, the geologic structures, weak planes or zones may be covered or routed to prevent percolation of water. So, weak zones, fissures, faults, they should be covered to prevent the percolation of water. This increases the compaction of the loose material. So, that loose material will also get compacted and get stable. That area will be stable, and that stable area will give us advantage that the landslide will not occur for the particular design time. So this is how, this is all about landslide subsidence and the earth flow, their causes, preventions, measures. We will study further in geology in the next class. Thank you.